are going to do something entirely different, as they used to say on Monty Python. We are going to talk about synthesizers. And the reason why I'm suddenly interested in synthesizers is mostly because I'm tired of some people recognizing their music on my videos. It goes to the extreme that somebody discovered a Cajun riff from the 1900s and claimed it was some kind of, I don't know what, summer song, where I would have to say, well, guess where you copied it from, you joker. But then again, let's not dwell on that. In this case, if you wonder where the organ is that played the intro to this, well, there is no organ. The whole thing has been played by a sequencer and a wavetable MIDI synthesizer. Both of these are freely available, and I'll leave a link down in the description for you to get it. But then again, this video is not really about wavetable synthesizers nor sequencers. It is about a mystery that has been occupying me for a long, long time. Back in those days when I was much younger and still trying to be an organ virtuoso, yeah, I had those days, there used to be a piece that we practiced up and down and down and up, and that would be one of Bach's trio-sonatas. Those were written by Bach for his son Friedemann, precisely for that purpose, to practice organ. And sincerely, nowadays they still do use those same trio-sonatas for two-handed play plus pedal for beginners. And I can't really disagree with them. Now, when it comes to the Trio Sonata 530 in G major, I always wondered if Mr. Bach hadn't cobbled it together on the run. And it's not like Mr. Bach is not known to do that, because, you know, maybe the most extreme case he ever had is he forgot to write a piece for the birthday of the Lord of the Realm. And what did he do? Well, he grabbed in his big pile, pulled the whole thing out, and changed the dedication. In fact, for many years, people were thinking that there were two concertos by Bach, one for his landlord and the other one for whomever. What I always suspected is that 530 was written for monophonic instrument, not like polyphonic, like the organ. And, well, until I ran into a synthesizer, I could never really prove it. There was no way for me. Yes, I could rewrite it, but where would I find people to play it? And even if I would have some people to play it to play it with, it still would be the changes and so on and so on. So now that I have a synthesizer, I readapted the whole Trio Sonata 530 to two flutes and a bassoon. And I think somehow I proved myself right to assume that this really was written for monophonic instruments and just cobbled together to make the trio sonata. In any case, you can judge by yourself, that will follow now. But before that, let me remind you, hey, if you like this, thumbs up. If you dislike it, thumbs down. And if you like my channel, please subscribe, it helps. Talk to you later.